About an artificial sun, a man-made sun. China wants to make it.
Artificial sun has set a world record by maintaining a temperature of over 100 million degrees Celsius. Take a look.
K-Star just reached a record-breaking 100 million degrees Celsius, far hotter than the sun's core at 15 million degrees. This Korean project, dubbed the Artificial Sun, is pushing the boundaries of nuclear fusion, where atomic nuclei combine to release immense energy. But what if we're on the brink of something even bigger? Could this breakthrough revolutionize energy production and change our future forever? Join us as we uncover what this achievement could mean for the future of humanity. The hidden potential of nuclear fusion. The past few months, we've seen some exciting progress in nuclear fusion. The latest news comes from China, where a special fusion reactor called the Experimental Superconducting Tokamak reached a big milestone. Nuclear fusion, which powers stars, involves combining hydrogen atoms into helium at extremely high temperatures and pressures. This process releases a huge amount of light and heat. Scientists are very interested in this method because it doesn't produce greenhouse gases or long-lasting nuclear waste. However, it's tough to create the same intense pressures on Earth, so our reactors need to get much hotter than the stars. But here's the tricky part. Keeping the plasma at these extreme temperatures without letting it damage the reactor walls. Scientists use lasers or magnetic fields to control it, which is very challenging. The recent experiment with the Chinese tokamak wasn't about achieving fusion just yet. It was more about testing whether the reactor could handle these high temperatures for a long time. The real challenge lies in making fusion a practical energy source. Despite some skepticism, these achievements show that we're getting closer. Each success from different projects around the world helps us move past the technological hurdles that stand in the way of fusion becoming a reality. Many people remain skeptical about putting a lot of resources into fusion energy. The costs in terms of time, money, and human effort are enormous, but so are the possible rewards. Experts have estimated that just a liter of seawater could produce the same amount of energy as 2 barrels of gasoline if used in a working fusion reactor. Also, fusion reactors could be much cleaner than our current energy sources, creating very little waste. Any waste produced could be reprocessed and reused. Today's fast-paced world of science, one of the most exciting developments is happening in nuclear power. China has just finished building a new kind of nuclear power plant that uses thorium instead of the usual uranium or plutonium. This idea was first tried in the US back in the 1960s, but was stopped due to a lack of money. The new plant is in the large Gobi Desert, and it's about to have a major test in the next 2 weeks, according to France 24. This could be a big moment for energy development. This new reactor works in a very interesting way. Most nuclear plants use uranium or plutonium, but this one uses thorium. Thorium reactors are special because they are more efficient and safer. They produce only 1% waste, with the other 99% being used to make hot steam. This steam then turns turbines to generate electricity, and the leftover steam cools back into clean water. Next, let's see how new reactor technology is changing nuclear power. The breakthrough revolutionizing energy. This breakthrough is about more than just making power. It's about changing how we live and use energy. The benefits go way beyond just making electricity. They offer a future where energy is plentiful, much cleaner, and safer. Working on this technology is not just a scientific project. It's a serious effort to change how we power our lives and grow as a society. With the world paying attention, China's test of this thorium reactor might set a new trend in nuclear power. This isn't just a technical success, but a bold move towards a sustainable future, showing big changes in power technology and the potential for safer, more reliable energy worldwide. Traditional nuclear power plants, fuel is housed in rods, but a new type of reactor, called a molten salt reactor, changes this a lot. In these new reactors, the fuel, often thorium, is not put in rods but mixed directly into a pool of molten salt. This big change offers several benefits. First, molten salt reactors run at much higher temperatures, but lower pressures compared to regular reactors. This means they can make electricity more efficiently, as explained by a nuclear engineer from MIT. Because of these conditions, the risk of explosive meltdowns, a big worry with traditional reactors, is much lower. The design of these reactors prevents high internal pressures, which helps avoid major accidents. And there's more. Molten salt reactors don't need to be near big bodies of water, unlike traditional reactors that need lots of water for cooling. The molten salts in these reactors handle the cooling on their own. This means these reactors can be built in more places, making them safer and more practical. France 24 reported that this is especially good for countries like China, which might not have large water sources near all potential reactor sites. Switching from uranium to thorium could change global politics a lot. Many countries depend on uranium from places like Canada and Australia. With thorium, which is more common in different parts of the world, countries could become less dependent on these uranium suppliers. This change could lead to more energy independence and stability, shifting the balance of power and resources globally. A country rich in rare earth metals, a groundbreaking project is taking shape. They are building the world's first molten salt reactor since the U.S. shut down its pioneering one at Oak Ridge National Laboratory in Tennessee back in 1969. This new reactor is special because instead of using uranium and water like most reactors, it uses molten salt and thorium. Switching away from uranium is a big deal. Traditionally, uranium-235 has been the go-to choice for nuclear reactors because it's been more economical. The market has always favored it, pushing alternative materials like thorium to the sidelines. The head of France's Alternative Energies and Atomic Energy Commission mentioned that thorium doesn't naturally start fission reactions like uranium-235 does. This means thorium-based reactors need more initial research, development, and money. But this wasn't the worst part. A nuclear reactor expert from the University of Pisa, in an interview with France 24, explained that using thorium in reactors is more complex and costly. It requires the use of expensive enriched uranium to get the reactions going. Nick Turan, a nuclear engineer who contributes to the What is Nuclear website, noted that these financial and technical challenges kept thorium-based nuclear technology from being further developed and invested in. Thus, the global nuclear industry stuck with uranium-235. Now let's explore China's advances in high-speed trains. The rise of China's nuclear revolution. However, the new Chinese reactor marks a significant technological advance. By choosing thorium and molten salt, China is not only broadening its nuclear capabilities, but also leading the way in what could be a more efficient and safer form of nuclear energy. This development might change how nuclear technology is seen worldwide, with more emphasis on sustainability and safety. Thorium is not as well known as uranium, but it has sparked many discussions about its potential in nuclear power. One big point of debate is whether its limited use in military applications has influenced its adoption for energy production. Some believe that because thorium is less useful for making weapons, it might be a reason why it's not as widely used for energy. But there's more to consider. Investing in thorium raises questions about diverting funds from renewable energy sources. According to an anti-nuclear activist in a report by The Guardian, thorium has its own set of problems. It creates dangerous byproducts like iodine-129, which has a half-life of 15.7 million years, and uranium-233, which is very radioactive. These byproducts require strict safety measures, as noted by a nuclear reactor expert from the University of Pisa in an interview with France 24. Yet despite these issues, technology investment trends show a clear pattern. China, for example, is more focused on funding new technologies compared to the United States, which is more market-driven. This trend is evident from a Reuters report in July, highlighting China's strategic push in sectors where market forces are less influential. This indicates a shift towards prioritizing innovation and technological advancement, potentially reshaping global energy strategies. China recently introduced a new maglev train that can travel up to 600 kilometers per hour, or about 370 miles per hour. This makes it the fastest ground vehicle in the world. The technology behind this train uses electromagnetic force, which allows it to float above the tracks without touching them. This floating happens because of strong magnetic fields created by large electric currents. This development is hugely important. For instance, traveling from Beijing to Shanghai, which is a very long trip, could now be done in just 2.5 hours. This fast travel not only makes trips more efficient, but also shows how advanced technology can significantly cut down travel times over long distances. Imagine being able to travel between major cities in China and potentially around the world much faster than ever before. This new train could change the way we think about transportation and make traveling long distances much easier and quicker for everyone. Traveling over 620 miles by train is quite a long trip. By plane, it might only take 3 hours. On a high-speed train, it could be around 5.5 hours. But if you were trying to gather the money for this trip in the United States today, it might feel like it would take forever. Meanwhile, China is making huge advances in technology. Recently, they successfully landed a rover on Mars on their first try in May of this year. This shows how quickly China is growing in technology and how they are moving faster than many other countries. Next, we'll look at China's big moves in space. China's astronomical leap. China has quickly boosted its space exploration efforts, achieving in a few years what took NASA decades. Roberto Orose, a planetary scientist at the Institute of Radio Astronomy in Bologna, Italy, recently shared his thoughts with Nature Journal, noting China's fast progress in space. But this is just the start of China's space dreams. China successfully sent 3 astronauts to its new space station. This station is a big upgrade from earlier versions, featuring 3 separate bedrooms and tripling the interior space for astronauts. Space.com reported this, citing Xinhua, China's state-run press agency, and the Associated Press confirmed it. These improvements show China's growing skills and ambitions in space. The country isn't just catching up with other space powers. It's also planning more advanced and long-term missions. The new space station, with its better living spaces, hints that China is gearing up for a more permanent human presence in orbit. But there's more to come as they prepare for deeper space missions in the future. The Chinese space station is planned to work for 15 years and might even outlast the International Space Station, which is nearing its end. This means that in the future, the only active space station might be Chinese. This is interesting because the United States once stopped China from joining the ISS. China also has big plans for space-based solar power. Recently, the Times of London reported that China wants to launch huge solar panels, nearly 1 mile long, into orbit by 2035. These panels would capture solar energy and send it back to Earth. This project includes building a new type of space station to collect solar power from space, where there's no atmosphere or day-night cycle to worry about. This method could change how we get solar power, providing a steady and huge amount of energy, and possibly transforming how we use energy around the world. But this wasn't the most surprising part. Imagine a place where solar panels stretch out wide, capturing the sun's energy without any interruptions like clouds or nightfall. This isn't just a scene from a sci-fi novel, it's becoming real, thanks to a big project led by Beijing. The Bishan Space Solar Energy Station, located in Chongqing, is a major step forward in this exciting plan. Here, an array of solar panels turns sunlight directly into electricity. But this isn't the best part. This electricity isn't used right there in space. Instead, it's sent back to Earth using advanced technology, either through microwave transmitters or laser beams. Once this energy reaches our planet, it's caught by a ground station, turned back into usable electricity, and then added to the local power grid. Right now, this project is still in its early stages. They have just started building the new facility, and by the end of the year, they expect to start initial tests. The plan is to have a working 1 megawatt solar power station by 2030. But that's not all. By 2050, the goal is to expand this to a huge scale, producing a gigawatt of power, equal to the output of China's biggest nuclear reactor. Now, let's dive into how China plans to get solar power from space. Space solar power. The idea of collecting solar power in space and sending it to Earth has been around since Isaac Asimov, a famous science fiction writer, first wrote about it in his 1941 short story, Reason. Even though various designs were thought up in the 1970s, none were considered cost-effective at the time. But things changed a lot when China took the lead, turning what seemed like a dream into a real groundbreaking project. But this isn't the end of the story. The impact of this project could be huge. Getting solar energy from space could lead to a nearly constant energy supply, not affected by the Earth's natural cycles and weather conditions. This could change everything in our search for sustainable, clean energy, marking a big shift in how countries approach power generation in the future. This project shows how innovative ideas can become reality with the right technology and determination. It could pave the way for more breakthroughs in how we harness and use energy, making a brighter, cleaner future for everyone. People have various reasons to criticize China right now. The country's actions in the South China Sea and its aggressive stance toward Taiwan are raising international concerns. Additionally, the situation in Xinjiang is deeply troubling, with many reports of human rights abuses. China's push to lead in new technologies has also faced major setbacks. For example, 6 months ago, the Taishan EPR nuclear reactor, known as the world's first of its kind, had serious problems. The French company co-owning the plant alerted the US when radiation levels got close to 90% of an already high safety limit. Despite this, it's believed that the Chinese operator pushed for even higher limits before a mandatory shutdown. Despite these issues, China keeps innovating in what anthropologist David Graeber called poetic technologies. These are big projects aiming to turn grand visions into reality through science and technology. For instance, China's progress in high-speed rail and digital infrastructure shows their commitment to transforming bold ideas into practical solutions. If you are more interested in small, steady technology improvements like the latest iPhone or the wide range of services offered by Amazon, you'll mostly find these in the United States. Figures like Elon Musk keep the US competitive, especially in space exploration and electric vehicles. However, China's story of fast technological progress alongside controversial political actions creates a complex picture. On one hand, China is a center for advanced technology. On the other, it faces global criticism for its political and social policies. This mix highlights the ongoing global debate about technology's role in society and the ethical issues it brings up. What do you think? Should we prioritize technological innovation over ethical concerns? Leave your thoughts in the comments, like, and subscribe for more.